Hi, everybody. Ted Jordan here with another installment of Professional Acting for the Long Haul. This week, we're going to be talking about what independent filmmakers are actually looking for from you as an actor. Now, it sounds really obvious, but to some, it really isn't. Here's the thing. What do you do when you first see an ad for an audition? As an actor, what do? You scan through the information, probably very quickly, and then you submit, right? But have you missed anything? I know I have, and sometimes I do because in the zeal of me trying to submit as fast as I can, even though there is a submission deadline, I sometimes miss out on important information. Like, maybe they want my age, or height, or where I'm from, or what role I'm actually submitting for. So no matter what it is, if you miss out on the information there, that's a possible stumbling block to you not getting the role. It's very important that you pay attention to the information that is sent out to you. Now, as independent filmmakers, sometimes they don't put all that information out there. They don't put it out there that it's non-union. They don't put out there that it's non-paying or it's a paying gig or that type of thing, or even where it's being shot or submission deadlines, or even put out there when they're going to be shooting it, you know, from January 14th to August 5th. Now, that's just an example, and it's a long, long shooting schedule. So, again, just an example. But you as the actor need to be aware of all the information that is required and give them that information, okay? Now, let's say you do that. What else is an independent filmmaker looking for? And even if it's not independent, this is general information that whoever you audition for, they're looking for it. They're looking for you to pay attention to those details that I just mentioned. And if you don't, you're X'd out of the opportunity automatically because they're assuming that you don't know how to adhere to information. You don't know how to pay attention to deadlines, and you don't pay attention to details. That's how stringent some people can be in this industry. And we're starting to get to that point because we're also dealing with people from a content producer, which I am. I'm an actor, but I'm also a writer, a director, and producer these days. And I create content. So we're looking for people that we can rely on, people who pay attention to detail, and people who communicate well. Now, we recently sent out sides to an actress that we were interested in working with, and we have still yet to hear from her. Now, in this industry, sometimes that's a way of telling people you're not interested in them or they're not interested in you, which really annoys me because if I put out the information to you and have taken the time to give you the sides, then you should have the courtesy and the professional respect to at least let me know if that role is really your role or not, or you're just not feeling it or something, letting me know that you got it and you're not really interested in that role. Now, I do that too, because when I receive scripts like with a lot of foul language in it, it really turns me off because from my point of view, from my opinion, it gets in the way of the story. Now, again, a lot of people use it, and that's fine if that's what you want to do, but at least I have the courtesy enough to let the people who sent me the information, I let them know that it's really not for me. That way they're not sitting around wondering if I got it, if I'm going to audition or not, because when we go and we're left to our imaginations, we always go negative. I have yet to go positive on something when someone hasn't done something they were supposed to do. My mind, my imagination is automatically going negative. And guess what? That's what independent filmmakers do. As independent filmmakers, we wear a lot of hats. Casting is one of those hats. And when we're not getting the information back, or if you're not adhering to a deadline, nobody is looking to chase you down. We're looking for good people who can be relied upon. If you want longevity in this industry, then be a person who can be relied upon. Have your professional mental hat on at all times, no matter whether it's an independent film or a big budget film through a studio. Either way, what we're talking about here is always going to help you in your walk, in this journey as an actor. These are the building blocks that you're going to need in order to succeed greatly. It's a hard road as an actor. I got it. I've been doing this for over 30 years. So I know, I understand. It's competition, it's crazy, it's wild. There's a lot of no's, but guess what? You can't control all that. All you can control is you and how you handle you to the very best of your ability. Again, I'm giving you the building blocks, the foundation on how to do this. Be a person of character. Be a person of integrity. Be a person who can be relied upon and can tell the truth and can give you and can communicate properly and honestly. You're a professional, one professional to another. Okay, I hope this was helpful to you, and I hope that whatever you may be going through right now in your career, this is going to help you get over that hurdle, that hump. The best way that's going to happen, though, is that you keep striving, you keep trying, and you don't give up and quit. If you have any questions, by all means, send it to our email at professionalactingforthelonghaul@yahoo.com. You can check out our website at crossingjordanentertainment.studio, and you can also check out our YouTube channel, Crossing Jordan Entertainment, and you can check out the rest of those videos there as well. Happy Thanksgiving! Gobble, gobble.